Cell script is basically a program that designed to be run by the Linux or Unix shell. Cell is a basically scripting is writing a series of commands for execution on shell. Basically, it's combination of the different commands which are we do manually execution on the shell terminal. So it can combine the lengthy and repetitive sequence of command into the single and simple script. It's a kind of a very simple text script which can be stored and executed anytime, and this reduces the effort required by the end user. So you don't need to run every time the same commands and doing the recall these all commands. So once you have the commands in a specific shell scripting, so you just have to run a simple single script only. So shell is a command line interpreter. Basically, it's typically operating by the perform the shell script, include the manipulation of a program and execution and printing the text output. Basically, there are two types of shell. There's one is a bourn shell and one is a C shell. Bourn shell, the prompt of this bourn shell is the dollar sign, and it's derived the listed below. So there are the three kind of bourn shell. POSIX shell is known as the SH. Con shell is known as the SH, and bourn again S shells also known as the base. So basically, base is the most popular shell in a Linux Unix systems, and we will going to deep dive the base shell in this tutorial. The second one is the C shell. The prompt for the C shell is the percentage sign, and there are two types: one is the C shell top C and C shell. So these are known as the CSH and TCSH. And in this tutorial, we will going to deep dive and we'll see the example of the base shell. Okay, so the first script of shell script, we will going to start the shell script. Basically, it's a simple plain text file which contains the series of commands, and it's a combination of command where you can run your commands over the terminal, which you have to make in a simple text file where you going to the combine all these commands. Okay, so there are some standard example for the name of your script. So how do you define your script name? So this here the some of example you're given. So there is the one is example hyphen one dot sh, example underscore, example one. You can make combination of character. I can start with the example underscore, so it's a valid name. So let's go for the terminal and create the simple first shell script, and let's start. So here I'm creating one file. So I have already created file, so let me remove my file. So I have created, and now I'm creating the new file. So basically, when you want to write the script, a shell script, you need a terminal where you can write. So it's kind of editor. There are the some of editors given by the Linux, like vi, vim, nano. You can use any of that. You can use the text editor also. Basically, I'm using here the Ubuntu for my scripting example, but you can use any Linux flavor, any Linux distribution system for doing the shell, because it's supported by the all Linux system. So let me create here the first script. Okay, so I'm creating the my first shell script. I'm giving them my base. Okay, so I'm printing here my first script. This is my first shell script. Okay, I'm saving this one. Okay, now I want to execute this file. Okay, so you can see the here the this is my first shell script. Okay, And here it will give the execution output using this symbol, the SS example.sh. And one more thing you have to understand, that's a permission for my script is I'm showing the command ls minus l example1.sh. Okay, so here you can see the I permission is set over, but I have already set, that's why it's showing the permission proper way. So here the different is read write x, read write x, and read write x. It's giving the execution permission.